Distrelec is one of the main sponsors, or is the main sponsor of the Electro Fast Forward Award at Productronica. So we ask a few questions at Mr. Andreas Suger. For the people who do not know Distrelec, can you please tell us something about the company?
Yeah, of course, with pleasure. Distrelec is a pan-European distributor of electronic components, tools and test and measurement instrumentation, as well as automation. And we've got a Swiss and a Swedish heritage. So originally we were founded in Switzerland in the 70s, but then we bought Elfa in the 90s, and Elfa's got a 75-year history in the area of electronics distribution. And our customers are spread all over Europe, and we've got local language support and technical knowledge. We've got key account offices in every country. And we try to be as close as we can to our customers. Even in the world of digitalization nowadays, we are investing heavily in the area of personalization. So we try to have a customer intimacy that is difficult to have in nowadays world of tablets and mobile phones and the internet, right? So we try to reflect that what we're currently doing and what we've been doing since 75 years in the digital world.
Okay, and you already mentioned a few, but in what aspects is Distrelec different from other distributors?
Yeah, we're different in the aspect that we have a smaller range than our competitors, but we really take care of that range, so we curate the range. We know which products are needed for what technology, and we therefore make customized product recommendations to our customers. Also, I mentioned personalization before, so we have a customer intimacy that our competitors probably struggle to reach. Also, we've got really good connections with key suppliers. Because of our 75 years history, there are suppliers such as Fluke in the Nordics that have a really strong relationship with us. And that relationship is only beneficial for our customers because we can give them direct access to our supplier.
Okay. And so we are from Electro Magazine. We have a lot of people who are doing electronics in their spare time, but they are also engineers. How does Distrelec support those engineers?
Yeah, there's a number of services that we do offer for our target customers. Target customers are not just buyers, but also engineers, as you mentioned. And for an engineer, things like technical attributes are typically the most important when it comes to product and component search. So what we do in order to support our customers is by customizing the search on the website. We get to know the customer by looking at the history, the search history. We will know over time what products and brands they typically look for and then can customize what we show them. But also we have services such as obsolescence notification. So if a manufacturer tells us that the product is no longer produced, we have to take it out of the range, but that's usually a problem for an engineer, right? Because you have your production line going and you need an alternative. So we have a service that then tells them, unfortunately, this product is no longer available, but we can offer you this alternative from the same brand, maybe from another brand. There are further services such as BOM tool upload, so on our website you can upload your BOM tool and we will tell you which of the components that we have, if we don't have them, what the alternatives are. We've got technical phone support.
Yeah, that was one of my questions. Technical support, if an engineer wants to know something, a detailed knowledge about a component, they can talk to Distrelec?
Absolutely, particularly when it comes to test and measurement and instrumentation. Like I mentioned before, the relationship that we have with our suppliers is very strong, particularly in the area of test and measurement. And we organize webinars on a regular basis with our suppliers. Just recently we had a Tektronix webinar where customers can log in and they talk about a certain topic such as IoT or power supplies for IoT. We have questions and answer sessions afterwards, and we also have a telephone support afterwards. Yeah.
Very good. So this is for single or engineering teams, but when I launch a production, a small production run, or maybe like a few hundred pieces, does Distrelec support that also?
I'd say the key benefit of Distrelec is, because we are in the area of high service distribution, is that we've got no MOQs at all. So you can basically, if you want to buy one resistor off our website, that I think is nowadays one of the key benefits. Also, we've got 24-hour delivery on the majority of our products that are in stock anyway. We've got a stock coverage of over 96%. So if you have a small production line that runs small batches, you sometimes have the need for short-term spare parts or short-term additional components because you may not have a huge warehouse. So you can just ring up Distrelec and tell them, I urgently need XYZ component and you have it within less than 24 hours.
And a question about the tools. So engineers, they love tools. That's a well-known fact. And you just mentioned the tools. How do you select your tools?
Well, it very much depends whether it's an own brand product or it's a brand at manufacturer. When we talk about brand at manufacturers such as Weha or Wera, these are typical hand tools manufacturers. We've got real good relationship with them and we see them at least four times per year. They make recommendations to us to present to us their latest innovations and product developments. And basically knowing each other so well, they know what's going to fit in our range. And there is a very short in-house evaluation period where we're going to select the latest technologies. And that's how it works with A-brands. When it comes to own brand products, private label products, just the tools that we see behind us, it's a completely different story. We work directly with the manufacturers there. Often they are in the Far East, but we've got a sourcing team in the Far East. So we're in touch with them. We tell them what our requirements are from a customer perspective, what the product must fulfill, and then they go out and about and find manufacturers that can produce according to our standards. We then receive samples back to Europe. Sometimes they stay in Asia depending on the complexity of the product, but sometimes also the sample comes back to Europe because we really want to get a hands-on test. We get feedback, make slight adjustments, and about 6 to 9 months later the product is in the range and available to buy.
Okay, so these are especially designed for Distrelec. It's not a rebranded other brand.
The majority of the tools are specially designed for Distrelec, yeah, because we want to find this little edge that might make the customer's life a little bit easier. So yeah, we do test products. We might take off-the-shelf products and think, what can we change or improve to make this product a bit more user-friendly. Also, when you think about all the instruction and documentation around the product, there's a big area where you actually spend a lot of time and money to make this as user-friendly as possible. Yeah, all the English or Chinglish descriptions that you sometimes see, you want to make sure that you translate this in the local languages, because we are a distributor that wants to be close to the customer, so we translated into German, into Swedish, into Italian.
Are you planning to design or develop your own brand test tools?
We already have a small range of private label test and measurement tools, and we are launching in December a new technology that I don't think is quite ready yet for being announced, but it's something that currently is not in the range of Distrelec, but we will make it available through our private label range because we've been working with these manufacturers over 1.5 years. I can tell you it's in the area of power. So what we're seeing here is a cross-section of the own brand product range, a very, very small portion of our 13,000 own brand products. But I think it's very representative because we have on the one hand side here test and measurement instrumentation, from a very simple multimeter to an endoscope to an LCR meter, a clamp meter, down to very simple tools such as pliers here, electronic or electric screwdrivers. Then we've got electromechanical components and electronic components such as an EMI filter or a motor capacitor. Something that is typically underestimated in terms of use is enclosures. We've got a range of over 1,100 different enclosures, different sizes, different materials that are still widely used for all sorts of applications. They're very universal in terms of the applications that they are made for. Then we've got down there more in the area of development kits, so the breadboard with the jumper wire set that is typically used by makers, but also in the area of engineering, electronics development. Startups often work with that type of product. And at the very bottom we see the tools kit. That is something that we work with schools with. Every year, a number of schools in the Nordics regions, particularly in Norway, work with us and evaluate what tools are needed for the next intake of students, and we then find tools kits that contain those tools and provide them in the thousands every year.
You sell many enclosures, and enclosures are important. Do you also provide enclosure customization services, if I need holes or cutouts?
Yeah, we can do that, absolutely. For the private label range, there is obviously a certain minimum order quantity then related to that customization. But if any customer needs a customized enclosure with certain cutouts, even different dimensions, we can absolutely do that. We didn't just need to talk certain quantities, but just get in touch with us, send us an email, call us up, and we can make a personalized offer. Then we have plans to actually offer that on the website in 2020. I've not mentioned that because I think for me it's not that much of a big deal in terms of further developments, but for the customer experience next year, you can on our website buy an enclosure and tell on the website where you want, what cutouts and what size. Yeah, and there the quantities are going to be lower than when you talk to us now about the private label range.
So Andreas, which is your favorite product?
It's a difficult question to answer. I think it's like as if you ask a parent with five children which one is your favorite child. But obviously I love the own brand product. It's my baby. It's what we created a bit over 3 years ago, and we've got over 13,000 products, and I love every single one of them.
You talk about mechanical tools, but do you also supply them with electronics tools like Arduino kits or similar prototyping tools?
Well, Distrelec absolutely has a very big range of single board computing and development tools. In the own brand range, not so much, because it's not an area where we can have a advantage in terms of technological development. We want to stay at the forefront of technology when it comes to single board computing and development tools, and that's why we decided that's not really relevant for the own brand product range. We want to focus with the own brand on the basics. But yeah, Distrelec is actually investing heavily at the moment in the area of single board computing. We work very closely with Arduino. We offer webinars with Arduino. We offer technical support and direct access to Arduino if there are any questions. And we have pretty much the whole range of Arduino in stock. So it's a very good partner of Distrelec, Arduino.
So you clearly cover the whole range from maker to professional engineer to industrial, etc. You have everything.
We can cover it all because that's usually how it starts, right? So every engineer that works in any big engineering firm typically also has a hobby that has to do with engineering, because in the end of the day, we like what we are doing, so we don't just want to do it at the job, but actually also outside of work. And we want to serve those needs in the professional area as well as in the private area.
Could you please talk about your plans and projects for 2020?
Yeah, Distrelec has got big plans for 2020. On the one hand side, we want to further invest into personalization. So we've got some projects in the pipeline to make the customer experience even more personal on the website, as well as when they call us up. Then the other plan is that we're going to go into another market, a European market. I think it's not the time yet to disclose what time and which market it is going to be, but it's going to be a European market and it's going to be a big thing. Then we're going to invest in the further expansion of the own brand product range, the R&D range. So we're going to more than double the private label range next year.
Okay, thank you. My colleague Denise has some questions about the Fast Forward Award.
So, you as a sponsor, could you share with us a general overview about our startup competition?
Yeah, so yesterday we've seen the 10 startups presenting their ideas, and we think there are at least 2 to 3 startups in there where we think they have breakthrough technology. So today I actually plan to go and have a more detailed conversation with them. Maybe also find out if we can support them in any way going forward with our services or our products. But yeah, I do not want to disclose too much yet about who our favorite is, to be honest.
About the startups, what is the interest of Distrelec in the startups?
Well, startups are usually very innovative. They have a certain way of looking at things and technologies and try to combine technologies in certain ways to make more than the sum of the individual technologies. That's what Distrelec is all about. We try to be at the forefront of innovation, just as the startups, and therefore we see a potential fit there, that a startup that is trying to leverage new technologies with a distributor that is trying to always be at the forefront of the new technologies, we think we can learn from each other, because we've got the 75 years of history of electronics distribution, they've got the mindset and the thinking of new technologies and the innovative thinking. So we want to learn from them what is new and how you can buy new technologies. They can learn from us how electronic sourcing works.
So Andy, now that you have seen the pitches from our finalists, what are your thoughts? Is it going to be hard to make a decision?
Yeah, I think it will be really hard. all three finalists are finalists because they have something to offer and their ideas and companies are convincing. The difficulty will be weighing up the different criterias against each other. So we've been looking at things like sustainability. Will the startup be surviving the hard world of reality out there? Has the startup got a real solution to a real problem? How did they pitch the innovation that they have? Will they be able to convince potential investors? Will they be able to convince potential customers? So that's the phase that we're currently in. And it's not easy, I must say.
Okay, exciting. Thank you.